Better be ready.
Thank you.
dish out stones!
That power number two displayed at the throne. Hard to believe he had that hidden in him. Lord Melchior said that number one was full of untapped potential as well. If I have the talent to use it...
Teresa, my lady, you seem angry.
Me? At what?
At me, for running away and joining Velvet.
Oh, that? I was careless. An enemy stole a tool of mine. I'm merely frustrated at my own incompetence.
A tool?
I don't care what happens to me now. Not as long as I can save Oscar.
I'm the one who hurt your precious brother. And you're asking for my help now?
Yes, you hurt him. You scarred his face, and his honor, and his heart.
Still holding a grudge then? Well, at least you won't be able to kill me in my sleep.
With no Malakim, I'm an ordinary woman. How could I threaten the Lord of Calamity? I'm painfully aware of my own weakness.
Good. Try to keep out of the way, then.
Lady Teresa, Velvet isn't so different from you. She had a little brother, she...
I know all about the Lord of Calamity, but none of that matters to me, as powerless as I am now. This is the only path for me. It's the only way I can save Oscar.
Lady Teresa...
Don't get careless!
Everyone ready to play?
Dark and light!
Stop fooling around.
Malakim are just tools.
What are you brooding over?
I know! Velvet, Eleanor, or Teresa. You're not sure whose little brother you want to be, eh? In that case, I assure you I'm the kindest of the lot.
The cruelest, most devious.
That's not what's on my mind. There's something I need to say to Lady Teresa.
Something you wish to say? Then speak, number two.
That's just it. I'm not number two. I'm Lafayette.
Lafayette?
It's the name Velvet gave me. It's very important to me.
Something can be important to you?
Yes. I have feelings. You see, Malakim are not tools.
Very well. I shall call you Lafayette from now on.
Thank you, Lady Teresa.
You're kinder than you look, my dear Teresa.
Thank you, Teresa.
You misunderstand. With so much at stake, I don't want to rock the boat.
Velvet, tell me what you know about Teresa and Oscar. I want a clear picture of what they can do.
All right. Teresa and Oscar are...
I can give you the lowdown on everything, Abby! Lady Teresa and Oscar are the best of the best! Even among the Praetors! Some call them the Consuls! There are only around 100 Praetors in the world, so we're talking very elite.
Anyone called a Consul is going to be adept at both fighting and leadership. They are key figures entrusted with responsibility for major cities and institutions.
The fighting part is all we have to worry about. Are they better than you, Eleanor?
Yes. I was a Primus, which is a full rank below them. I could never overcome Teresa's arts or Oscar's swordsmanship in our practice battles.
When they were still trainees, they worked together to wipe out dozens of demons in a single night! After that, Lord Melchior kept a close eye on them.
Appreciated. I'll be on my guard.
Together they sound like a real threat. Thankfully, we're only after Oscar alone.
But Oscar has mastered a new art developed by Lord Melchior! You can count on it being a nasty one.
You really do know a lot about this stuff.
It's a little suspicious.
You think so? Well, I was at the Abbey, so...
Why don't you call him Lord Oscar?
That's what's bothering you? It's because we're both so popular with the ladies. I consider him a rival.
Thank you.
It's a beetle.
Yeah. A Lionel giant thunder stag beetle, to be exact.
Why do they always have such awkward names?
I think it's a cool name.
I've never been able to figure out why boys are so drawn to these things. What's the matter? Didn't you want to see it?
Yeah. Thanks.
When he was little, Oscar was always running around the woods collecting bugs. He'd get so into it, it was never long before he'd trip and hurt himself.
Did you grab bugs for him?
Yes. I thought they were gross. But I was much taller than him, and I had the reach. Once, he gave me a whole pile of cicada shells as his way of thanking me. I just screamed.
I'm sure he just wanted you to know how he felt. I can relate to that.
Rather unusual for a Moloch like you to contemplate such things.
Well, I try to. It's just really hard sometimes.
It's hard for people, too. Sometimes it feels insurmountable. And yet we can't give up. Sometimes you just have to say what you believe in your heart, even if you're not good at saying it.
What I believe.
V, hurry up already!
What were you two talking about?
Nothing.
Lafayette, found a new stag beetle, did you?
Yeah, Lady Teresa caught it for me.
Ooh, those pincers are sharp. Aizen, take a look at this fine specimen of a stag.
Wait, I believe that might be a two-horned rhinoceros beetle.
Listen, you two. If you're gonna get in another fight over this, I'll just say it's a new type of drone beetle.
You wouldn't.
You've really figured us out, huh?
Eleanor, you didn't make him say that just now, did you?
I did not. I've made a pact with him as a vessel, but he isn't tethered to me.
A Moloch, acting so human.
I used to think that way. Molochim possessing free will just like humans? It was inconceivable. But meeting Lafayette and Aizen taught me the truth. They laugh in joyful times, and cry in sad times. Their stomachs even growl too.
Their stomachs growl?
Now I take it as a matter of course that not only Molochim, but demons and Therians, too, have their own thoughts and feelings.
I thought you hated demons.
I certainly still do, but now I feel something besides just hate.
Molochim with free will? Demons and Therians as well?
You must have sensed that in Lafayette, or you wouldn't have caught that beetle for him. When you saw his beaming face, it must have reminded you of when Oscar was a young boy. Am I correct?
This conversation's over.
Teresa, be honest. Isn't there something wrong with the Abbey using a dangerous experimental art out in the field?
Oscar's the one who decided to go through with it. Don't presume to know anything about who he is. Using that art could be fatal. I can't allow Oscar to try it.
Lady Teresa, is something the matter?
It's nothing. I'm fine.
But you looked like you were in pain.
Oh. I was just thinking a bit.
You didn't have time to rest after recovering from the Corsair's scourge. You're awfully hard on yourself, you know.
And even harder on others, am I?
That's not what I meant.
It doesn't matter. I'm well aware that I'm stone cold. But they say a Moloch never knows his vessel's heart. I said nothing all those times you snuck off to the library, did I?
You knew about that?
Of course I knew. But I was just letting you roam free like a master might let her little pup. Number one didn't wander about like you did. What makes you different?
I'm sorry.
Well, boys will be boys, I guess. But I was planning on punishing you if that behavior continued.
Punish me how?
You don't want to know. It might wreck your good cheer.
Lady Teresa!
Look at how open she's being. Do you really think she'll work with us?
I don't think she's lying to us. But I don't think she's being entirely truthful either. Look, I know I probably don't have to say this, but...
You don't. I won't let my guard down. If I see anything funny, she's dead. And since she has no Moloch, it'll be quick.
Thank you. Everyone ready to play?
They were nothing. Teresa, let's review our plan before we go in.
All right.
We'll tell Oscar that we'll release you if he gives up his weapons and Malakim. We'll tie him up, collect the Therian, and then head for the docks. Once we're aboard our ship and ready to sail, we'll release you. You'll be free to do whatever you want.
Very well. But I want you to promise me one thing. Promise me you won't hurt Oscar.
That depends on him. I'll defend myself if I have to.
Velvet...
Please, do it for me, too. If you want to save Oscar, you need to make him listen. Put your own life on the line. You're his sister. Do whatever you have to protect him.
I will. Even if it means my death. We're almost at the Earth Pulse point. You all know the plan, right?
I'm using you as a hostage to keep Oscar from doing anything stupid. And don't you try anything funny either. I'll end this quickly.
I knew you'd come, Velvet. Sister!
As plain as day. Now put down your sword and let go of my fairy. If you don't, I'll kill her.
You coward!
I'm sorry to do this, Oscar! I'm searching for the truth behind the Abbey's talk of so-called reason.
And your idea of reason is to threaten my dear sister's life?
I'm sorry, Oscar. I've become nothing but a burden.
Teresa, no. It's not like that. All right. I'll put down my arms. Teresa, get back!
Forgive me, Oscar. This is the only way I can protect you.
We've kept our end of the bargain. Take him and get out of here.
I can't do that. It will reflect poorly upon him.
Lady Teresa?
Have you forgotten? You're just a powerless human.
You're right. I am a weak, worthless human. But he has shown me the light. And it shines. My body is receptive to Enominat's power. And with it, I can protect everything I care about.
She turned into a Therian?
No, she fused with it.
I'll kill you all. Anything to protect Oscar.
Do you realize what you're doing, Teresa?
A trivial sacrifice. I'd do anything for my Oscar.
Yeah!
turning back. Not with so much at stake.
His future depends on this.
Stand down, or I'll devour you piece by piece.
It's okay, sister. You've done enough.
No, don't look at me. I'm so hideous.
When I was growing up, the only one my mother and father ever paid any attention to was my older brother, the heir. But you, Teresa, you noticed me when they didn't. You looked after me, supported me, smiled for me. I could never thank you enough, my sister. Keep watching over me, Teresa. As long as you're looking after me, I can vanquish even the Lord of Demons. Take a good look. This is armatization.
My enemy! I'm sorry!
people hurt my sister.
He's losing control of the Moloch!
Damn it! It's turning into a dragon!
Velvet, quick! Devour that thing! Stop! He's still...
for my birthday. They're family heirlooms that were supposed to go to his fiancée, but he didn't know that at the time. I told him he should give them to the woman he cares most about in the world. And you know what he did? He smiled at me and said I was that woman. So sweet, so innocent. And you took him away! You killed my Oscar! How could you? How could you? How could you? No!
Don't do it!
Teresa, Oscar. And we didn't even get the Therian we came for.
Oscar came at him first. I had to. It was for Luffy. For my little... Just dead. I killed them. I'm the same as Artorias. I killed her brother before her very eyes.
It's not the same.
It is the same! But I didn't have any choice! It was the only way to avenge you! It was all for you! I did it for you!
There's nowhere left to run.
Nowhere for you or for me.
Hmm.
nowhere left.
You all right?
I ate too much. That's all.
They were close. They supported each other ever since they were children.
I just did to them what they were going to do to us.
And who will killing them save?
The soul of my murdered brother.
Whatever the case, we messed up the Therian part of the plan. They're probably making a new one as we speak.
There's no time to waste. Let's go back to the port and start our search.
Yeah. I had to do it. All of it.
Velvet! I never expected that Velvet would actually eat Teresa.
What else could she do? We never expected that Teresa would be a Therian either.
Velvet and Lady Teresa weren't so different. They both loved their brothers.
Not everyone loves their brothers. Some just want them dead.
So where does this leave us?
It seems we must search for the new Therian that will fill the void left by Teresa.
It won't be easy to find another who could become a Therian.
Then it won't be easy for the Abbey either. And they still may not be able to awaken Innominat. We still can't assume that we're in the clear, though.
No, we can't.
If it takes time for the Therian to be reborn, this could be our chance to strike.
Whatever happened, the Seven Therians' ties have been severed from Innominat. But we won't know if the Empyrean has been weakened until we find out for ourselves.
I can try and see if I can sense the new Therian. So let's go back to the prison island first. But I think Velvet needs time to rest.
Right. If we're gonna take down Artorias, she has to be there with us.
Yeah.